see it. Seeing her coming out of the darkness like a ghost ship still gets me every time. To see the sad ruin of the great ship sitting here, where she landed at 2:30 in the morning of April 15th, 1912, after her long fall from the world above.
You were so full of shit, boss. Down the roof of the officer's quarters like yesterday.
Sure.
Okay, near two. We're on the land of an overground staircase. You guys set the launch?
Yeah, Brock. Launching Duncan now. Go, drop.
Okay, Brock. Drop it down along the hull.
Yeah, roger that. Okay, drop down and go into the first class gangway door. I want you guys working the D-deck.
Reception area in the dining center. Copy that.
Tether up.
Tether up.
Okay, now left. Now left.
Okay, come
left,
on left. Left. Come on left.
Snoop Dogg is on the move. We're headed down the stairwell.
Okay, let's drop down to B-deck.
Some rope, Cap.
B-deck, get in there. Get in there.
Back to the right.
door. Get closer.
You smelling something, boss?
I want to see what's under it.
Give me my hands, man. You seeing this, boss?
It's payday, boys.
Same thing happened to Geraldo, and his career never recovered.
Turn the camera off.
Doc, partners would like to know how it's going.
Hey, Dave. Barry, hi. Look, it wasn't in the safe.
But hey, don't worry about it. Still plenty of places it could be. Hell yes. The floor debris in the suite, the mother's room. First is safe on C-deck.
Jimmy Hoffa's briefcase.
A dozen other places. Guys, look, just got to trust my instincts. I know we're close. Just got to go through a little process of elimination.
Hang on a second.
Listen to that. We might have something here, guys.
Where's the photograph of the necklace?
We'll call you right back.
Been underwater for 84 years, and my team are able to preserve it intact. Should this have remained unseen at the bottom of the ocean for eternity, we can see it.
Oh, my God, Dave.
Satellite call for you. Bobby, we're launching. You see the submersibles going in the water? Trust me, buddy. You want to take this one.
It's got to be good.
Now, you got to speak up. She's kind of old.
Great. This is Brock Lovett. How can I help you?
This is Calvert. Rose Calvert.
Mrs. Calvert.
I was just wondering if you had found the heart of the ocean yet, Mr. Lovett.
I told you you wanted to take the call. All right, you have my attention, Rose. Can you tell us who the woman in the picture is?
Yes, the woman in the picture is me.
Die on the
Abrams all right?
Oh, yes. Very nice. Well, have you met my granddaughter, Lizzie? She takes care of me.
We met just a few minutes ago. Remember, Nana, up on deck?
Okay. There. That's nice. I have to have my pictures when I travel.
Can I get you anything? Is there anything you'd like?
Yes. I would like to see my drawing.
Louis XVI wore a fabulous stone that was called the Blue Diamond of the Crown, which disappeared in 1792. About the same time old Louis lost everything from the neck up. The theory goes that the Crown Diamond was chopped too, recut into a heart-like shape that became known as the Heart of the Ocean. Today it would be worth more than the Hope Diamond.
It was a dreadful heavy thing. I only wore it this once.
You actually think this is you, Nana?
It is me, dear. Wasn't I a dish?
I tracked it down through insurance records. An old claim that was settled under terms of absolute secrecy. Can you tell me who the claimant was, Rose?
I should imagine someone named Hockley.
Nathan Hockley, that's right. Pittsburgh steel tycoon. The claim was for a diamond necklace his son Kaladin bought his fiancée. You. A week before he sailed on Titanic. It was filed right after the sinking. So the diamond had to have gone down with the ship. You see the date?
April 14th, 1912.
Which means if your grandmother is who she says she was wearing the diamond the day the Titanic sank.
And that makes you my new best friend. These are some of the things we recovered from your stateroom.
This was mine. How extraordinary. And it looks the same as it did the last time I saw it. The reflection has changed a bit.
Are you ready to go back to Titanic?
Okay, here we go. She hits the berg on the starboard side, right? She kind of bumps along, punching holes like Morse code, dit, 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 along the side, below the waterline. Then the forward compartments start to flood. Now, as the water level rises, it spills over the watertight bulkheads, which unfortunately don't go any higher than E-deck. So now, as the bow goes down, the stern rises up, slow at first and faster, until finally she's got her whole ass is sticking up in the air. And that's a big ass. We're talking 20, 30,000 tons. Okay, and the hull's not designed to deal with that pressure. So what happens? She splits right down to the keel, and the stern falls back level. Then as the bow sinks, it pulls the stern vertical, and then finally detaches. Now the stern section just kind of bobs there like a cork for a couple of minutes, floods, and finally goes under about 2:20 a.m., 2 hours and 40 minutes after the collision. The bow section planes away, landing about a half a mile away, going 20, 30 knots when it hits the ocean floor. Pretty cool, huh?
Thank you for that fine forensic analysis, Mr. Bodine. Of course, the experience of it was somewhat different.
Will you share it with us?
Taking her to rest.
No.
Come on, Nana.
No!
Tell us, Rose.
It's been 84 years.
It's okay. Just try to remember anything. Anything at all.
Do you want to hear this or not, Mr. Lovett? It's been 84 years. And I can still smell the fresh paint. The china had never been used. The sheets had never been slept in. Titanic was called the Ship of Dreams. And it was. It really was.
Some controls, but not about Titanic. It's over 100 feet longer than Mauritania. Far more luxurious.
Your daughter's found too difficult to impress you.
So this is the ship they say is unsinkable.
It is unsinkable. God himself could not sink this ship.
What? The chief of baggage. The name's unknown. He found that way, sir. I put my faith in you, good sir. I finally see my man.
Yes, sir. My pleasure, sir. If I can do anything at all.
Yes. Nice. All the trunks from that car there. 12 from here. And a safe. To the parlor suite, rooms B-52, 54, 56.
Back to America in chains. Outwardly, I was everything a well-brought-up girl should be. Inside, I was screaming.
What's that, idiot? What's happened?
Jack, your party, but everything here.
When you got nothing to lose.
Another anciana, and the fuck that is going to be there.
If you're worth anything, I'm sure you're going to be out of the box.
Sven?
All right. Moment of truth. Somebody's life's about to change. Niente.
Niente.
Olaf? Nothing. Sven? Oh. Too fair. I'm sorry, Fabrizio.
Che sorry, ma vaffanculo, ti ripeto, oh,
I'm sorry, you're not gonna see your mom again for a long time. Cause we're going to America.
Full house, boys!
No!
Not a usling.
Come on, figlio di puttana!
I'm going home!
Per quanto di Dio! Cazzo che mi giura! Per te, da te!
I'm going home! I go to America!
No, mate! Titanic go to America in 5 minutes!
Come on, come on, come on, come on! We're riding the high style now! We're coming with regular swells! Practically goddamn royalty!
Of course.
Anyway, we don't have any lights. We're Americans. Both of us. Right. How about that? Luckiest sons of bitches in the world, you know that?
They certainly were a waste of money.
The difference between Cal's taste in art and mine is that I have some. They're fascinating. Like being inside a dream or something. There's truth, but no logic. What's the artist's name? Something Picasso?
Something Picasso. He won't amount to a thing. He won't, trust me.
Put the guy in the bedroom.
At least they were cheap.
Put it in the water.
At Cherbourg, a woman came aboard named Margaret Brown. We all called her Molly. History would call her the unseekable Molly Brown.
Well, I wasn't about to wait all day for you, Sonny. Here, you think you can manage?
Her husband had struck gold someplace out west, and she was what Mother called new money. By the next afternoon, we were steaming west from the coast of Ireland, with nothing out ahead of us but ocean.
Take it to sea, Mr. Murdoch. Stretch your legs. Yes, sir.
Head full, Mr. Moody.
Very good, sir.
Thank you.
moving object ever made by the hand of man in all history. And our master shipbuilder, Mr. Andrews here, designed her from the keel plates up.
Well, I may have knocked her together, but my dear was Mr. Ismay's. He envisioned a steamer so grand in scale and so luxurious in its appointments that its supremacy could never be challenged. And here she is, willed into solid reality.
Here.
She knows.
We're both on the lamb. Rare, with very little mint sauce, eh? You like lamb, right, sweetie?
You gonna cut her meat for her too there, Cal? Hey, who thought of the name Titanic? Was it you, Bruce?
Well, yes, actually. I wanted to convey sheer size. And size means stability, luxury, and above all, strength.
Do you know of Dr. Freud, Mr. Ismay? His ideas about the male preoccupation with size might be of particular interest to you. What's going on here to you? I do apologize.
She's a pistol, Cal. Hope you can handle her.
Well, I may have to start minding what she reads from now on, won't I, Mrs. Brown? Freud, who is he? Is he a passenger?
I saw my whole life as if I'd already lived it. An endless parade of parties and cotillions, yachts and polo matches. Always the same narrow people, the same mindless chatter. I felt like I was standing at a great precipice, with no one to pull me back, no one who cared or even noticed.
Let go.
presume to tell me what I will and will not do? You don't know me.
Well, you would have done it already.
You're distracting me. Go away.
I can't. I'm involved now. You let go and I'm gonna have to jump in there after him.
Don't be absurd. You'll be killed.
I'm a good swimmer.
The fall alone would kill you.
It would hurt. I'm not saying it wouldn't. To tell you the truth, I'm a lot more concerned about that water being so cold.
How cold?
Freezing. Maybe a couple degrees over. You ever been to Wisconsin?
What?
Well, they have some of the coldest winters around. I grew up there near Chippewa Falls. I remember when I was a kid, me and my father, we went ice fishing out on Lake Wissota. Ice fishing is, you know where you...
I know what ice fishing is!
Sorry. You just seem like, you know, kind of an indoor girl. Anyway, I fell through some thin ice. And I'm telling you, water that cold, like right down there, it hits you like a thousand knives stabbing you all over your body. You can't breathe. You can't think. At least not about anything but the pain. Which is why I'm not looking forward to jumping in there after you. Like I said, I don't have a choice. I guess I'm kind of hoping you'll come back over the rail and get me off the hook here.
You're crazy!
That's what everybody says, but with all due respect, miss, I'm not the one hanging off the back of the ship here. Come on. Come on, give me your hand. You don't want to do this. Jack Dawson.
Who's doing big hitter?
I have to get you to write that one down.
You wanted to see the propellers.
Like I said, women and machinery do not mix.
Was that the way of it?
Yeah. Yeah, that was pretty much it.
Well, the boy's a hero then. Good for you, son. Well done. So, it's all well, and that's our brandy, eh?
Ah. It must be freezing. Let's get you in some.
Perhaps a little something for the boy.
Of course. Mr. Lovejoy, I think a 20 should do it.
Is that the going rate for saving the woman you love?
Rose is displeased. To do. I know. Perhaps you could join us for dinner tomorrow evening. To regale our group with your heroic tale.
Sure. Count me in.
Good. Settle then.
want to tie that. It's interesting. The young lady slipped so suddenly and you still had time to remove your jacket and your shoes.
Feelings for you.
Is it a
diamond? Yes. 56 carats to be exact. It was worn by Louis XVI. And they called it Le Coeur de la Mer.
The heart of the ocean. Ocean.
Yes.
It's overwhelming.
That's royalty. We are royalty, Rose. You know, there's nothing I couldn't give you. There's nothing I'd deny you. If you would not deny me. Oh, open your heart to me, Rose.
Drawn from life?
That's one of the good things about Paris. Lots of girls willing to take their clothes off.
You like this woman. You used her several times.
Well, she had beautiful hands, you see.
I think you must have had a love affair with her.
No. Just with her hands. She was a one-legged prostitute. See? Oh. I should have good sense of humor. Oh, and this lady. She used to sit at this bar every night, wearing every piece of jewelry she owned, just waiting for her long-lost love. Called her Madame Bijou. See, her clothes are all moth-eaten.
Well, you have a gift, Jack. You do. You see people.
I see you.
And?
He wouldn't have jumped.
But the purpose of the university is to find us here. Rose has already done that. Look, here comes that vulgar brown woman. Quickly get up before she sits with us.
Hello, girls. I was hoping I'd catch you at tea.
We're awfully sorry you missed it. The Countess and I were just off to take the air on the boat deck.
What a lovely idea. I need to catch up on my gossip. Countess?
So you've not yet lit the last four boilers?
No, I don't see the need. We are making excellent time.
The prisoner's the size of Titanic. Now I want them to marvel at her speed. We must give them something new to print. This maiden voyage of Titanic must make headlines.
Mr. Ismay, I would prefer not to push the engines until they've been properly run in.
I'm just a passenger. I leave it to your good offices to decide what's best. What a glorious end to your final crossing if we were to get into New York on Tuesday night and surprise them all. Make the morning papers. Retire with a bang, eh, EJ? Good man.
Well, after that, I worked on a squid boat in Monterey. Then I went down to Los Angeles to the pier in Santa Monica and started doing portraits there for 10 cents apiece.
Why can't I be like you, Jack? Just head out to the horizon whenever I feel like it. See, we'll go there sometime to that pier. Even if we only ever just talk about it.
No, we'll do it. We'll drink cheap beer. We'll ride on the roller coaster till we throw up. Then we'll ride horses on the beach, right in the surf. No, but you'll have to do it like a real cowboy. None of that side saddle stuff.
You mean one leg on each side?
Yeah.
Can you show me?
Sure, if you like.
Teach me to ride like a man.
And chew tobacco like a man.
And spit like a man.
What, they didn't teach you that in finishing school?
No.
Come on, I'll show you. Let's do it. Come on, I'll show you how. Come on.
Jack!
Come
no,
on.
Jack! No! Wait, Jack! No, Jack, I couldn't possibly, Jack.
Watch closely.
That's disgusting!
All right, your turn. Pitiful. Come on, you really gotta hock it back, you know? Get some leverage to it. Use your arms. Arc your neck. Can you see the range on that thing?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, go. Oh, that was better. You gotta work on it.
Really?
Really try to hock it up and get some body to it, you know? You gotta...
Jack Dawson. Charmed, I'm sure. The others were gracious and curious about the man who'd saved my life. But my mother looked at him like an insect. A dangerous insect, which must be squashed quickly.
Well, Jack, sounds like you're a good man to have around in a sticky spot. Why do they always insist on announcing dinner like a damn cavalry charge?
Shall we go dress, Mother? See you at dinner, Jack.
Son? Son!
Do you have the slightest comprehension what you're doing?
Not really.
Well, you're about to go into the snake pit. What are you planning to wear?
I figured. Come on. I was right! You and my son are just about the same size.
Pretty close.
You shine up like a new penny.
Good evening, sir.
She'll be along. There is the Countess. Hello.
Good evening, Count.
I saw that in the Nickelodeon.
Darling, surely you remember Mr. Dawson?
Dawson? That's amazing. You could almost pass for a gentleman.
Almost.
Extraordinary.
Benjamin Guggenheim and his mistress, Madame Aubert. Mrs. Guggenheim is at home with the children, of course. And over here we have Sir Cosmo and Lucille Lady Duff Gordon. She designs naughty lingerie, among her many talents. Very popular with the royals.
Congratulations, Hartley. She's splendid.
I thank you.
Care to escort a lady to dinner?
Certainly. Sweet pea.
Ain't nothing to it, is there, Jack? Remember, they love money, so just pretend like you want a gold mine, and you're in a club. Hey, Aster!
Well, hello, Molly. Nice to see you.
JJ, Madeline, I'd like you to meet Jack Dawson. How do you do?
Pleasure. Hello, Jack. Are you of the Boston Dawsons?
No, the Chippewa Falls Dawsons, actually.
Oh, yes.
He must have been nervous, but he never faltered. They assumed he was one of them. Heir to a railroad fortune, perhaps. New money, obviously, but still a member of the club. Mother, of course, could always be counted upon.
Tell us of the accommodations and steerage, Mr. Dawson. I hear they're quite good on this ship.
The best I've seen, ma'am. Hardly any rats.
Mr. Dawson is joining us from the third class. He was of some assistance to my fiancé, I suppose.
It turns out that Mr. Dawson is quite a fine artist. He was kind enough to show me some of his work today.
Rose and I differ somewhat in our definition of fine art. Not to impugn your work, sir.
Maybe my husband. She's gone. He belongs to Thomas
Abbott. It's all for me. Just start from the outside and every way in.
He knows every rivet of that, don't you, Thomas?
Your ship is a wonder, Mr. Andrews, truly.
Thank you, Rose.
How do you take a caviar, sir?
No caviar for me, thanks. Never did like him much.
And where exactly do you live, Mr. Dawson?
Well, right now my address is the RMS Titanic. After that, I'm on God's good humor.
And how is it you have means to travel?
I work my way from place to place. You know, tramp steamers and such. But I won my ticket on Titanic here at a lucky-handed poker. A very lucky hand.
All life is a game of luck.
A real man makes his own luck. Right, Dawson?
And you find that sort of rootless existence appealing, do you?
Well, yes, ma'am, I do. I mean, got everything I need right here with me. Got air in my lungs and a few blank sheets of paper. I mean, I love waking up in the morning not knowing what's going to happen or who I'm going to meet, where I'm going to wind up. Just the other night, I was sleeping under a bridge, and now here I am on the grandest ship in the world having champagne with you fine people. I'll take some of that. I figure life's a gift, and I don't intend on wasting it. You never know what hand you're going to get dealt next. You learn to take life as it comes at you. There you go, Cal. To make each day count.
Well said, Jack.
Yeah.
To make me count.
To make me count.
You want to go to a real party?
Thank you.
Rockefeller said that the Supreme Court is not swallowing him.
To see that boy again. Do you understand me?
Rose? I forbid it.
Oh, stop it, Mother. You'll give yourself a nosebleed.
This is not a game. Our situation is precarious. You know the money's gone.
Of course I know it's gone. You remind me every day.
Your father left us nothing but a legacy of bad debts hidden by a good name. That name is the only card we have to play.
I don't understand you.
It is a fine match with Hockley. It will ensure our survival.
How can you put this on my shoulders?
Why are you being so selfish?
I'm being selfish.
Do you want to see me working as a seamstress?
Is that what you want? To see our fine things sold at auction? Our memories scattered to the winds?
We're women. Our choices are never easy.
bright, and keep them by thy watchful.
Hello, Mr. Andrews.
Hello, Jack.
Sir, I just need to see somebody for a second.
You're not supposed to be in here speaking to someone.
I was just here last night. You don't remember
no,
me?
No, I'm afraid I don't. Now you're going to have to turn around.
I'll tell you. I just
need to... Mr. Hockley and Mrs. DeWitt Bucate continue to be appreciative of your assistance. They asked me to give you this in gratitude.
I don't want your money, please.
Also, to remind you that you hold a third-class ticket and that your presence here is no longer appropriate.
I just want to speak to Rose for
gentlemen,
one second,
all right? Please see that Mr. Please. Dawson gets back to where he belongs and that he stays there.
Yes, sir. Come along, you.
Yes, let me ride to thee for those who perish on the sea.
And why do you have two steering wheels?
We really only use this near shore.
Excuse me, sir. Another ice water. This one's from the Norden.
Thank you, sir. Oh, not to worry. Quite normal for this time of year. In fact, we're speeding up. I've just ordered the last boiler's lid. Inside this one. But it was thought by some that they were too cluttered. So I was overruled.
A waste of deck space as it is, or a single ship.
Sleep soundly, young Rose. I have built you a good ship, strong and true. She's all the lifeboat you need. Just keep heading aft. The next stop will be the engine room.
Amazingly astounding, wonderful girl, woman that I've ever known. And
Jack,
let me try and get this out. You're a mate. I'm not an idiot. I know how the world works. I've got $10 in my pocket. I have nothing to offer you, and I know that. I understand. But I'm too involved now. You jump, I jump, remember? I can't turn away without knowing you'll be all right.
Well, I'm fine. I'll be fine. Really.
Really? I don't think so. They've got you trapped, Rose. And you're gonna die if you don't break free. Maybe not right away because you're strong, but... sooner or later, that fire that I love about you, Rose, that fire is gonna burn out.
It's not up to you to save me, Jack. Leave me alone. Tell Lucille about the disaster you had with the stationers.
Well, of course, the invitations had to be sent back twice.
Oh, my dear.
And the dreadful bridesmaids, yeah. So let me tell you what an odyssey that has been.
Rose decided.
Thank you.
was the last time Titanic ever saw daylight.
So we're up to dust the night of the sinking. 6 hours to go.
Incredible. There's Smith, and he's standing there. He's got the iceberg warning in his fucking hand. Excuse me, his hand. And he's ordering more speed.
26 years of experience working against him. He figures anything big enough to sink the ship, they're going to see in time to turn. The ship's too big with too small a rudder. There's a corner with a dam. Everything he knows is wrong.
It's quite proper, I assure you. This is the sitting room. Will this light do?
What?
Don't artists need good light?
That is true, but I'm not used to working in such variable conditions. Monet.
Do you know his work?
Of course. Look at his use of color here, isn't it great?
I know, it's extraordinary. Cal insists on carting this hideous thing everywhere.
Will we be expecting many times soon?
Not as long as the cigars and brandy hold out.
That's nice. What is it, a sapphire?
A diamond. A very rare diamond. Jack, I want you to draw me like one of your French girls. Wearing this.
All right.
Wearing only this. Of me looking like a porcelain doll. As a paying customer, I expect to get what I want. Tell me when
it
looks right.
Put your arm back the way it was. Right. Put that other arm up, that hand right by your face there. Right. Now, head down. Eyes to me, keep them on me. And try to stay still.
I believe you were blushing, Mr. Big Artiste. Can't imagine Monsieur Monet blushing.
He does landscapes. Just relax your face.
Sweet.
No laughing.
My heart was pounding the whole time. It was the most erotic moment of my life. Up until then, at least.
So what happened next?
You mean Did we do it? Sorry to disappoint you, Mr. Bodine. Jack was very professional.
None of these stewards have seen it.
It's absurd. It's a ship. There's only so many places she could be. Lovejoy, find her. Maintain speed and heading to the light. Yes, sir.
It's getting cold. You look nice.
Yes, sir.
My drawings. This fella seems more like a cop.
I think he was.
Oh, shit.
there. Balls. Rocket or what?
Did you ever find those binoculars from the lookout?
I haven't seen them since Southampton. Well, I'll be on my rounds. Cheerio.
Missing.
That's what it takes for us to get warm. I'd rather not, if it's gonna save me here, all right?
Thank you.
Dutch haven here. Smell ice, can ya? Bleeding Christ.
Not the time, entered in the log. What was that, Mr. Murdoch?
An iceberg, sir. I put her hard a starboard and the engine's full of stern, but it was too close. I tried to port round it, but she hid. And
close the watertight doors.
The doors are closed, sir.
All stop. Find the carpenter and get him to sound the ship.
Yes, sir.
I shouldn't worry, madam. We've lightly thrown a propeller blade. That's the shudder you felt. May I bring you anything?
No, thank you.
If this is the direction the rats are going, that's good enough for me.
There is no emergency.
Yes, there is. I have been robbed.
Head the master at arms.
Now, you moron!
Yes, sir.
Hey, gonna miss the fun.
You see what happened?
No, I missed it. Apparently, it hit over there.
Boiler room 6 is flooded 8 feet above the plate, and the mail hold is worse. She's all buckled in the forward
hold. Can you shore up?
Not unless the pumps get ahead.
Have you seen the damage in the mail hold?
No, she's already underwater.
This is bad.
We should tell Mother and Cal.
I think they're very good, sir. Don't touch anything. I want the entire room photographed.
Just keep hold of my hand. Here, sir. Do you know what's going on?
We've been looking for you, miss.
Oh, here we go. Something serious has happened.
Yes, it has. Indeed. Two things dear to me have disappeared this evening. Now that one is back, I have a pretty good idea where to find the other. Search in.
Take your coat off, son.
Now what?
Come on, now.
Cal, what are you doing? We're in the middle of an emergency. What's going on?
Is this it?
That's it.
This is horseshit! Don't you believe it, Rose? Don't!
He couldn't have.
Of course it could. It's easy enough for a professional.
Come on.
But I was with him the whole time. This is absurd.
Perhaps he did it while you were putting your clothes back on, dear.
Real slick, Calrose. They put it in my pocket.
Shut up.
It isn't in your pocket, is it, son? Property of A.L. Ryerson. That was reported stolen today.
I just borrowed it. I was going to return it.
Oh, an honest thief. We have an honest thief here.
You know I didn't do this, Rose. You know it. Don't you believe them, Rose. You know it. You know
come
I didn't
on, son,
do
let's
it.
Let's go. Come
Rose,
on.
You know I didn't do
don't
it, Rose.
Pick up,
Rose.
Come on. There's a good lad. Come on, son. There's a good lad. Come on.
You know I didn't do it. You know me.
Water, 14 feet above the keel in 10 minutes. In the 4P, in all three holds, and in boiler room 6.
That's right, sir.
When can we get underway, damn it?
That's 5 compartments. She can stay afloat with the first 4 compartments breached, but not 5. Not 5. As she goes down by the head, the water will spill over the tops of the bulkheads at E deck from 1 to the next, back and back. There's no stopping it.
The pumps, if we open the
doors... The pumps buy you time, but minutes only. From this moment, no matter what we do, Titanic will founder.
But this ship can't sink.
She's made of iron, sir. I assure you, she can. And she will. It is a mathematical certainty.
How much time?
Two at most.
And how many aboard, Mr. Murdoch?
2,200 souls on board, sir.
Well, I believe you may get your headlines, Mr. Ismay.
it is a little slut, isn't it? You look at me when I'm talking to you.
Mr. Hockley.
Not now. We are busy.
Sir, I've been told to ask you to please put on your life belts and come up to the...
Said not now.
I'm sorry to inconvenience you, Mr. Hockley, but it's captain's orders. Now, please, dress warmly. It's quite cold out tonight. Now, may I suggest top coats and hats?
This is ridiculous.
Not to worry, miss. I'm sure it's just a precaution.
Life belts on!
What? What's he on about?
Everyone else, put your life belts on! Mr. Rogers, just put your life belts on!
CQD, sir?
That's right, CQD, the distress call. What's our position? Tell whoever responds that we're going down by the head and need immediate assistance.
Yes, sir. Sir, they need you up in the second class post office. Speak more up.
Go on. I'll keep an eye on it.
Aye. Right.
Said, nice and cheery, so there's no panic. Wedding dance.
Life belts on. Put your life belts on. Put your life belts on. Yeah, put your life belts on.
But you first-class people in the vault will be starting with us, and we want to be our ready, won't we?
Lower away! Left and right together!
You know, I do believe this ship may sink. I've been asked to give you this small token of our appreciation. Compliments to Mr. Caledon Conklin.
Come on, sister, you heard the man. Into the boat.
Any room for a gentleman, gentlemen?
Only women at this time, sir.
Let the lifeboats be seated according to class.
They're not too crowded.
Oh, Mother. Shut up! Don't you understand? The water is freezing and there aren't enough boats. Not enough by half. Half the people on this ship are going to die.
Not the better half.
Come on, Ruth, get in the boat. First class seats are right up here.
Oh. You know, it's a pity I didn't keep that drawing. It'll be worth a lot more by morning.
I'm going
love to put in my pocket.
I know.
Listen, Rose, you're gonna have to find a spare key, all right? You have to look in that cabinet right there. It's a little silver one, Rose.
These are all brass ones.
Check right here, Rose. Rose, how did you find out I didn't do it?
I didn't. I just realized I already knew.
Keep looking.
Oh. No key. There's no key.
All right, Rose, listen. You're gonna have to go find some help. You'll be all right.
I'll be right back. there something you don't see every day.
Sure of the weight, Miss Brandhurst. These boats may buckle.
Rubbish. They were tested in Belfast with the weight of 70 men. Now, fill these boats, Mr. Whitehall, for God's sake, man!
Please! I need more women and children, please!
Back to us!
Mr. Hockley! You two with me now!
I'm a businessman, as you know. I have a business proposition for you.
This way, I'll lead you.
What's the use? Nobody's listening to us anyway.
Well, they don't listen to us at dinner either. Come on, let's play. Keep us warm. Orpheus.
He's in the ground, boy. Now I know I'm in first class. Where is everyone?
They're all still off, sir.
Understanding then, Mr. Murdoch.
Stop! No!
Why'd you do that, huh? You're so stupid, Rose. Why did you do that? Why?
You jumped, I jumped, right?
Right.
Oh, God. I couldn't go. I couldn't go, Jack.
It's all right. It's all right.
At least I'm with you.
It's all right.
Come on!
the fools hooked up!
Thank you.
privilege playing with you tonight.
Thank you. Come on. Here. Keep swimming. Come on. Here. Get on it. Get on top.
If we go back, they'll swamp the boat. They'll pull us right down, I'm telling you.
Knock it off. You're scaring me. Come on, girls. Grab an oar. Let's go.
Are you out of your mind? We're in the middle of the North Atlantic. Now, do you people want to live or do you want to die?
I don't understand a one of you. What's the matter with you? It's your men out there. There's plenty of room for more.
And there'll be one less on this boat. If you don't shut that hole in your face. Now bring in your oars over there. And tie these two boats together as well. Now make sure that's tied up nice and tight. We have to go back. I want to transfer all the women from this boat into that boat right now, as quick as you can, please. Let's create some space over there. Move forward and up.
It's getting quiet.
It's just going to take a couple of minutes to get the boats organized. I don't know about you, but I intend to write a strongly worded letter to the White Star Line about all this.
I love you, Jeff.
Don't you do that. Don't you say your goodbyes. Not yet. Do you understand me?
I'm so cold.
Listen, Rose. You're gonna get out of here. You're gonna go on. And you're gonna make lots of babies. And you're gonna watch them grow. You're gonna die an old lady, warm in her bed. Not here. Not this night. Not like this. Do you understand me?
I feel my body.
Winning that ticket, Lois, was the best thing that ever happened to me. It brought me to you. And I'm thankful for that, Rose. I'm thankful. You must do me this honor. You must promise me that you'll survive. That you won't give up. No matter what happens. No matter how hopeless. Promise me now, Rose. And never let go of that promise.
I promise.
Never let go.
I'll never let go, Jack. I'll never let go.
sir.
Oars! Do you see any moving?
No, sir. None moving, sir.
Check them! Bring that oar up here. Check them, make sure.
These are dead, sir.
Now give way. Head easy. Careful with your oars. Don't hit them. Is there anyone alive out there?
Thank you.
1,500 people went into the sea when Titanic sank from under us. There were 20 boats floating nearby, and only one came back. One. Six were saved from the water, myself included. Six out of 1,500. Afterward, the 700 people in the boats had nothing to do but wait. Wait to die. Wait to live. Wait for an absolution that would never come.
Sir, I don't think you'll find any of your people down here. It's all steerage.
The last time I ever saw him. He married, of course, and inherited his millions. But the crash of 29 hit his interests hard, and he put a pistol in his mouth that year, or so I read.
Can I tell you your name, please, love?
Dawson. Rose Dawson.
We never found anything on Jack. There's no record of him at all.
No, there wouldn't be, would there? And I've never spoken of him until now. Not to anyone. Not even your grandfather. A woman's heart is a deep ocean of secrets. But now you know there was a man named Jack Dawson. And that he saved me in every way that a person can be saved. I don't even have a picture of him. He exists now only in my memory.
Got it. I never let it in.